Chief! Chief, this guy threw fucking hot coffee in my face!
Yeah, I should probably just let it lie for a little bit.
Probably.
Well, I'm saying I'm on scene. I've got a minivan here. Stand by.
110, exiting Braddock Pass. Speeds are 75, continuing southbound. We are aware of spikes at Union. We're clear.
Take one step to your left. Continue backwards. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Stop. Go to your knees.
New dispatch. Law. Disturbance / nuisance. 3049 Procopio DR. 3049.
110, I'm clear on my call assignment. I'll be en route. Hello?
Hey, Chief, it's Corporal Biggs. Are you busy?
Yeah, a little bit.
Just give me a call back when you got a minute. I got a guy out here at the motel. I just wanted to let you know about it.
Okay, I'll call you back.
Wait here for a moment.
What's going on, man?
Nothing. Just trying to get my late night coffee and people fucking it up.
Oh, yeah? What'd they do?
A hot coffee. And I just can't understand the lack of care of the younger generation or any kind of responsibility.
What was wrong with the coffee?
Well, I it's hot as shit out here. I didn't want a hot coffee. So
right.
I asked for, just an iced, coffee, 3 creams, 3 sugars, and I get this piping hot fucking cup of bullshit, and I threw it at him.
Oh, you threw it at him?
Yeah. Teach him to fuck it up.
Well, I mean, I get being mad about it, but, throwing a hot drink at somebody, you could do some serious damage to their face, man.
I mean, you're probably right, but I feel the kid deserved it.
Chief! Chief, this guy threw fucking hot coffee in my face!
Oh, I didn't know you worked down here, O'Reilly.
Yeah, I got all a part-time job because it pays okay.
I understand. Okay. Did you bring him out here, John?
No.
Then put him back inside, please.
Yeah, come on.
I'll come talk to you in a minute. I'll come talk to you in a minute, Chris.
I can't believe he did that.
Jesus Christ. All right.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
All right, man. Look, dude, I understand, but, if you threw a hot drink in his face and you burned him pretty good, I mean, he's got grounds for assault charges, man. You don't want that.
Hmm? Yeah, you're right.
I mean, I know you don't want that. I mean, I know your intention here wasn't to hurt the guy, but at the end of the day, you did,
Yeah.
So, okay. All right, man. Here's what we're going to do. At this point in time, I'm just going to detain you. You're not under arrest, and more than likely, even if he wants to press charges, you're not going to jail, okay? That's not how I roll, all right?
Okay, well.
So, what I would like for you to do is, do you have any weapons or anything on you?
No, I don't.
Okay, do you mind if I just pat you down?
Sure.
All right, we're going to just turn around, face away from me, all right? We're gonna forgo the handcuffs. We will completely, we'll just forgo the handcuffs. I'll just have you have a seat in the car where it's air-conditioned, and we'll just figure this all out, okay? I don't see any reason to hook you up or nothing like that, okay?
Yeah, the Yeah, the car will be probably nicer than standing out here in the heat.
Okay. Hey, man, you don't have to answer this question if you don't want to, but this thing that I'm squeezing right here kind of feels like a badge. What's this?
Oh, it's a town council badge.
I'm sorry. Let's just walk over to that Tahoe right there.
Yeah, so I don't know if we still have it, but I was a member of Marina Beach Town Council.
Oh, okay. All right, man. All right.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm sorry I didn't recognize you then, partner.
Mm-hmm. No, that's okay.
Go ahead and hop in the back for me. Oh, hang on. Hang on one second. There you go. Just hop in the back for me.
All right.
There you go. All right. Just sit tight for me. I'll be right back with you, okay?
Okay.
You want me to turn that music off or anything?
No, it's fine.
Okay.
I like it.
All right, Chris, what happened?
Oh, I was in there, you know, just sitting here, whatever. He come in, he ordered a coffee, and I made it for him, and apparently he wanted it cold, and I made it hot. So I said, okay, well, I'll just remake it for you. And then he goes on this tirade about how that's unprofessional, and you know, I need to pay attention to what I'm doing, and blah, 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 you know, whatever. And you know, I'm like, hey, look, you know, just calm down. I'll remake it. And then he starts insulting me and stuff and saying I have a unibrow and everything, which I can't control that. You know, I try to shave it and wax it and stuff. But, you know, sometimes it's hard to maintain. So, right. You know, at that point, I told him, like, look, you can just leave. I don't want to serve you anymore. You've been rude. You've been nothing but mean to me. And you can just take your stuff and go. You can call in the morning about a refund. I'm just leave.
Okay.
And then he wouldn't do that. So I call 911. We went back and forth for like 4 or 5 minutes about it. And then I called 911 to get somebody out here to, you know, just make him leave. And then while I'm on the phone, he realizes I'm calling a 911. And then he just throws the hot coffee in my face and it gets in my eyes and, you know, it hurt. Okay. And then you guys showed up. And then, yeah.
All right. Let me have a look at your face, Chris.
Okay.
Up and rinse out the coffee from his eyes.
Okay, all right. Okay, all right, man. It doesn't look all that. I mean, I realize you got hot coffee thrown in your face. It doesn't look all that serious, which is good.
Yeah, it just didn't really hurt, you know? He was kind of being a dick about it the whole time.
All right. So, go ahead and, do you have a... Do you have on your register over there? Can you show me a receipt from the order you rung in? How did he pay? Did he pay with cash or card?
It was card. Yeah,
can I see
the
receipt?
Yeah, yeah. Hang on. Let me squeeze past you. Thank you.
Huh?
Is he in your car?
He's in my car. Yeah, he's in my car. Okay. He is not handcuffed, but he's in my car.
I'll go sit with him.
Okay.
Okay. Here you go.
All right, let's have a look here. Okay, all right. And you didn't hear him say he wanted an iced coffee?
I may have misheard him. I don't know. Maybe I hit the wrong button.
Okay, all right. And then you, okay, yeah, I mean, because he just...
Yeah, I just kind of...
I kind of see why
you
do a one iced coffee, you know. It's kind of hot. It's still 83 degrees outside right now, you know what I mean?
Yeah, no, I mean, yeah, you know, people come in here, order all kinds of stuff. I don't really judge. And then, yeah, I'm like, I'll be honest, I'm half paying attention. And then I just kind of look back at the receipt and see, you know, where the little printout sticker thing. And I look what I put on there if I forget. And I don't know. But, I told him I'd remake it. I told him it wasn't a problem. And then, you know, he just starts doing all that for no reason.
All right, man. Okay. So at the end of the day, I don't really feel like I know it hurt, but like you're not showing any serious injury. I'm not sure that assault charges are appropriate. What do you want to do here, Chris?
I just, at least, you know, have him trespassed, especially if he's going to act like that.
Okay. All right. We can do that. We'll go ahead and do that. All right. We'll have him trespassed. That's totally fine. Are you okay with that then?
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. That's yeah. Okay. He's right, some kind of councilman or something. I don't know.
Yeah, apparently. So, okay, man, no problem. All right, Chris, we'll take care of that for you. I'll bring the trespass for a minute and let you sign it as a witness.
Okay.
And we'll go from there, okay?
Okay, that's fine.
All right, buddy, hang out.
Yeah, so you're getting a lot of issues with, like, service workers. Just semi-common.
Huh? Sorry.
You getting a lot of, like, arguments with service workers?
No. This is, the first time I've gotten perturbed.
All right, sir. You know, I apologize. I didn't catch your name. Sir.
Sorry. Yeah, it's Johnson J. Johnson.
J. Johnson. Okay. Johnson J. Johnson. Okay. All right. Well, here's what's gonna happen, Mr. Johnson. He is not interested in pressing assault charges, so we're not gonna go down that road. He is interested in issuing a criminal trespass on the property. So what I'm going to do is I am going to have to honor that. And I'm going to give you two options here. One is contact management or corporate and get that rescinded. You could do that by phone, okay? And they have the power to rescind that since it's their property. And two, just so you're aware, I am going to go ahead and write that as a 30-day trespass. So it will lapse in 30 days.
Okay, yeah, that's fair. I was out of hand.
So, yeah, I think it might just be cool to just, you know, give it a little break, kind of let it all simmer down, and then we'll go from there. So, you just for my record, you acknowledge that you're trespassed, and you can't come back here at least for 30 days, or until you speak to management and have it rescinded.
Yes, I acknowledge that.
All right, fantastic. So what we're going to do then is, at this point, I have no reason to further hold you. I'm just going to have you step out of the car and sign this trespass form for me. It's not an admission to guilt. Just let me know that you're going to take care of it. And then we're going to move on from there, okay? I'm going to get you out of the car.
All right.
You can go ahead and step out.
All right.
Okay, if you could just sign this form for me. Like I said, it's not an admission to guilt. It's just an acknowledgement of receipt. 30 days or until it's rescinded. I mean, you can call them Monday morning and probably get that taken care of, okay?
Yeah, I should probably just let it lie for a little bit.
Probably, but I don't really want to see somebody trespass from a place. I realize that what you did was inappropriate, but so do you. So, I mean, we can let bygones be bygones here. So, okay?
Okay.
All right, well, at this point, you're free to go.
All right.
And I hope you have a better rest of your night, okay?
All right, appreciate it. You guys as well.
All right, Mr. Johnson, thank you.
All right, take care.
I'm going to have O'Reilly sign this.
I'm going to, like, pop in and out of the book.
Okay. All right, Chris, go ahead and sign over here in the witness form for me. Or on the witness box for me.
Yeah.
So it's a 30-day trespass. And, I mean, he has the option of contacting corporate and getting it rescinded. So if one of those, if 30 days lapses or he does contact manager or corporate and gets it rescinded, don't be surprised if you see him back in here, okay?
Okay.
I have no control over that, okay?
Right, yeah.
So if you could just sign there for me. Thanks, buddy. I appreciate it. All right, man, you don't need to see a medic or nothing. I mean, it doesn't look bad to me, but I'm not a medic, so...
Yeah, no, I'm fine.
All right, buddy. Okay. All right, you doing okay otherwise?
Yeah, no, I'm good. I just picked this up because, you know, when I can't pick up with Rook, you know, it's easy money to do this,
man.
And there's tips and stuff. So.
So, hey, man, just as a suggestion, okay, when you're working in service, it is kind of important to pay attention. You know, I would hate to think that, you know, when you're working for me, you're not paying attention. So I'm sure your boss here would like you paying attention to what your customers tell you. I don't know what he told you. He says he told you iced coffee. I wasn't here. I don't know. And I'm not going to argue about it. You know what I mean? But you told me earlier that you were only paying half attention and all that good stuff. And, I mean, honestly, I get where you're coming from, dude. I remember working jobs like this. I remember letting my mind wander, too. But at the end of the day, we should strive to do our best in everything we do, right?
Right, yeah.
All right. All right, Chris. Well, have a good rest of your night, okay?
Okay, you have a good one.
All right, buddy. Take care. 110, I'll be clear off this call and I'll be back in service.
Canada, Toledo 110, is 115 still there?
Negative, sir. He had to log off.
Copy. I have a call pending that will probably require more than a few years, so. We're at 3004 for Copia Promenade. Business alarm. Reports a glass break at the front door. Hawthorne Street.
I'm clear. Start me 5603.
O3 copy direct and already enrolled.
Copy. 113 is just cleared from the traffic. He's heading up there as well.
46, I think we're sufficient at this time.
New dispatch. Oops. Law. Alarms. Procopio Promenade. 3004. New dispatch. Law. Alarms. Procopio Promenade. 3004.
One ten, I'm entering the township. I'm gonna approach John Procopio.
I'm on scene. One ten, do we happen to disregard. One ten, I'm on scene. I've got a minivan here. Stand by. 110, one taking off, gray minivan, didn't get a plate.
Direction of travel.
Coming towards you, down Procopio. One ten, he's fair to yield, I'm secondary. We are headed back out towards US Route 1 at this time. Left on US 1.
Copy, I can have spikes at Union.
Copy, 110, clear. Spikes at Union, continuing US 1, traffic is light, speeds are moderate.
Driver of the gray minivan, pull over to the right. This is the police.
110, crossing Polito, headed out of the township now. Speeds are moderate, traffic is light. Radical 110, entering Braddock Pass. Speeds continue to be moderate. Traffic continues to be light. Update, speeds are now high. We are preparing to enter Braddock Tunnel. Speeds are 80.
O3 to you. Unit, be advised, he's sticking his hand without the winch for reason to.
Be advised, spikes at Union.
110, exiting Braddock Pass. Speeds are 75, continuing southbound. We are aware of spikes at Union. We're clear.
I'm making faith.
Copy.
Okay, that's cool. Yeah.
Keep your hands out!
Driver of the vehicle! Open the door from the outside!
Abby, I'm behind you. 110, go ahead and start medics this way. We're stopped. 2025. Get county medics.
Walk backwards!
Oh, you're about to step on me.
Ow!
Take one step to your left. Continue backwards. Keep coming, keep coming, keep coming. Stop. Go to your knees.
I can see that the inside of the car is clear. We need to clear the trunk when we move up.
Trunk looks clear from here.
Copy. I'm going to move up to the female that's down.
Copy.
All right, ma'am, don't move. Do not move. Keep your hands out where I can see them.
Ow. Shit hurts.
All right. Let's go ahead and get you set up. What hurts?
Yeah, I can see him. Trunk's clear.
I walk back here. Just
have a seat on the ground for me, alright? Your head hurts?
Yeah.
Right.
I got thrown around in the car. Y'all try to kill us.
We try to kill you. You want to just, do you want to flex that Y muscle, get up and have a seat?
Let me get there.
That works, that works.
Runner back.
Hey, Parks?
Yeah.
When you get a minute, get somebody to trade and get Tabitha over here.
Okay.
Man, if things were work at the correct
don't
speed.
Don't you reach for that gun, okay? Take or Anderson. One of you take him.
Incoming 911.
He wants.
Incoming 911.
You guys want to be over there for her. Right, let me get this gun off him.
Okay.
Try
a. Boy, I'm really trying to sit.
Try E-sit.
All right,
I am. It's just. The typing is lagging for no good fucking reason.
I understand.
Okay.
He's alright.
Yeah, I'm gonna put him in this.
Do you have any weapons on you or anything, ma'am?
Okay.
No, I threw out the bat.
Okay, alright.
Hey, guys! Ammunition just
Tabby,
got
she's trying to sit down, but,
Okay.
Go ahead and, just pat her down. Anybody who's not busy, they can clear to go to that. Did you say the ammunition just got robbed?
Yeah, they say they just got robbed for 70% of their products.
They really should be closed at 2 in the morning,
yeah.
But alright.
Really? Okay.
Yeah, go ahead and pat her down.
Alright, you got any weapons on you, ma'am? Anything sharp?
Let's go, Tuck.
My name, Jesus.
No.
You going to that right now?
No.
Dueling.
Okay.
He just said
yeah.
Clearing.
I don't have anything.
Come with me.
Alright. Verica Cortez.
You need to go to that?
Fucking car.
Yeah, go.
Okay, what's the postal?
Got it. It'll be the ammunition in Sandy, I believe.
Alright, she's good. Where do you want her?
Put her in my car, I guess.
Okay. Come this way, ma'am.
You get it. Their food was trash. And then they wanted me to pay for some trash food. And then they got me charged. I had to do what I had to do.
Had to do what you had to do, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
119, go.
So, what exactly was it you had to do?
I'll be available.
Make them pay for it.
Okay. And how did you do that?
I broke their
shit. One time.
Okay.
Right. You might have to put her in your
down
car.
To your guys' end of the pursuit. Everybody's like 119, dude. He can save his township.
He can save his township. We're clear at this time.
Hold on, I'm struggling on a different front. There we go.
Yep.
Let's do it this way.
You might.
Let's do it this way.
Okay.
Have a seat in the car, ma'am.
Oh, nope.
Uh-oh.
Not that way. Not that way.
Is she not in handcuffs?
No.
She was.
Okay, put her back in handcuffs. Or see if you can.
It says she's cuffed.
Oh, I just put her in the car.
Weird. Whatever. Technical difficulties.
I think you're about to steal my car.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, yeah, you know how to fix on. That.
I think so.
I'll just, I'll leave you to it.
Okay, did you go through the car there at all?
No.
Okay.
Oh,
shit, that's my girl. I'm
okay. Cops roll up. She hops in, she says, go! Okay, fuck it.
Yes, sir.
I'm running.
Would you like
hey, man,
to...
what'd you scream at me when I pulled up, dog?
I didn't say shit, fool.
Alright, you said something.
She said something.
Alright, one of y'all said something.
Yeah, no, I mean, I saw you roll up. She hop in the car, she's like, go, dog, go! So, I all fucking right. jump in and ran off, man.
What was that shit all about, dog?
I don't know, man. I'm running for her. She said she had to go to Bayview to do something. I'm like, alright, cool. So, I ain't got shit to do. So, I drove her up there from Los Santos. Wow. And we rolled up. She starts breaking shit. I'm like, damn, this bitch crazy. It's kind of why I dated her, though. And
fair enough.
And all then you roll up. She hop in. She's like, go, go. I'm like, all right, fuck it.
Hmm. Okay. All right, man. Why didn't you stop when I signaled you, man?
I ain't stopping no cops, man. Fuck that.
All right. All right, man. Sit tight.
All right.
He had a gun on him. I'm about to check on that.
All right, cool.
He's well. He's on there.
Is he?
Yeah.
Anything in the car?
Nah.
Cool. All right. 110 dispatch. I can get one Times County tow out here for a van in the ditch.
I saw her get out with like a bat. Where's that at?
She actually tossed out the window.
Oh, okay. Nice.
So, yeah, she asked for shiny weapons on her. She said she tossed it out the window. So.
I'm gonna see what the deal is with this gun.
All right. Cool. Also, 110, you can go ahead and start Times 2 F2 wagon this way. All right, man. What's your name, partner?
Jesus.
Jesus what?
Varega Cortez.
All right, Mr. Varega Cortez. At this point, just wanted to let you know you're under arrest for fleeing and eluding, okay?
Yeah, I figured that.
All right, man.
Mr. Cortez, you ever been in trouble with police
before? Ma'am, how come you didn't tell him to stop when y'all was running?
Because we were running.
Because you were running? Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, at this point, you're under arrest.
Okay, that's fair.
All right. So, I mean, I'm just curious, really. Like, you said they served you some bad food?
Yeah.
How bad was bad food?
I mean, it was really bad. The other cop, that, yeah.
Didn't I tell you not to go back there?
Well, they got me charged for their incompetence. So I had to get my revenge.
You told her not to go back there, like, in what way?
Criminal trespass.
Oh, so, like, she's trespassed from there? Like, as of today?
Criminal trespass. Yeah, literally first thing.
What'd you go back there for, then?
To break their shit!
Okay, alright. Shit, alright.
They made me mad.
It kinda looks like your wagon's pulling up. Let's go ahead and get you out of the car, ma'am. What'd you say your name was? I think you can
Sophia
step out.
Sophia Gomez.
I think you can step out. I think that's you're okay. It. Yeah, there we go. All right, Miss Gomez. All right, you're going to head off with these deputies
black
right
top.
Here, and you're going to have a better rest
you're
of your night, okay?
Right.
Am I actually
handcuffed? I believe that
hold on.
The cowboy hat and shade. I stopped him early along with 113. Then we got Harry.
You're not, but it says you are.
That's weird.
I'm going to recuff. Hold on.
Oh.
I'm going to recuff you and then uncuff you.
Sweet.
That should fix it. Ah, you should be good.
Sweet. Up and away. Oh, God. Things have occurred.
Take two on that up and away.
Yay! Goodbye.
Do you want charges on him, or you want me to take them?
I got him.
Okay.
I got him. He initiated the pursuit in the township. He had the gun in the township. He took her to the township to do criminal damaging.
Okay.
I will take the charges on him. He weapons under? I think I heard John say he was.
He was weapons under.
I didn't look.
Okay. All right. Well,
that gun comes back to some completely unrelated individual to him. Some white dude from frickin' mainland.
Okay, cool.
He said his homie gave it to him, and then he bought it off his homie. So that's clearly an illegal sale.
Cool, 9/10 and all that.
Yeah.
I'm gonna roll around and see if I can help them find whoever robbed the fucking gun store here.
Alright, I'm gonna head back over to the township.
Yeah, how the fuck did they rob the gun store at 2 in the morning?
2 in the morning, yeah.
I'm confused.
Maybe it's a B&E, I don't know.
Burglary, yeah.
I guess.
But who called and said they lost 70% of their shit?
They saw it on the live feed. They got a little alert from the security or some shit.
I don't know, man. It sounds a little hinky to me.
It sounds like they got shitty security if they didn't stop the crime. Where they just watch the crime?
I guess.
Monitoring system, I don't know.